Let us discuss about piezoelectric accelerometer. This accelerometer will find the acceleration or vibrations of a given motor or given machine or given engine. How many vibrations the engine is making during running. Okay, so here what is the use of finding the vibrations? As we know, if engine or motor or vehicle, any vehicle has more vibrations, it will not run properly for a long term. Okay, it will not function properly for a long time, and then sound pollution is also more. For avoiding it, first we have to find how many vibrations are coming from a given engine. So for finding the vibrations or accelerations, we are using different types of accelerometers. So here take the first type, it is piezoelectric accelerometer. Why we are calling piezoelectric accelerometer means we are using in this accelerometer piezoelectric effect for finding the vibrations. So that's why this accelerometer is called piezoelectric accelerometer. Let us take the basic principle of piezoelectric accelerometer. Here I am taking some piezoelectric crystals like this. These are different in shapes, different in direction. Okay. Let us assume we are measuring the vibrations here, acceleration. Okay, that acceleration force we are applying here. Okay, vibration force we are applying here at both sides of the crystals. Because of application of this force or because of vibration force, these crystals will change its orientation. Means it will change the direction. Let us assume after application of force, this horizontal will come in this direction. Okay, some vertical crystals will come in the horizontal directions like that. If orientation of the crystal will change, electric voltage will develop inside these crystals. Okay, this voltage will take by the electric wires. Here we have to keep electric wires for taking the voltage produced by this crystal. This voltage will measure the vibrating force. Okay, this voltage will measure the vibrations. It is the main basic principle. So in the short form, we can tell basic principle. This accelerometer is based on the piezoelectric effect. Piezoelectric effect means whenever we are applying the force, voltage will develop. That is called piezoelectric effect. This accelerometer is based on piezoelectric effect. That is, when a piezoelectric crystal is subjected to mechanical force, okay, or stress along a specific planes, a voltage is developed or generated across the crystals. If the force on the crystal is due to the acceleration, a measure of the voltage across the crystals, okay, becomes a measure of acceleration. Okay, when calibrated, it will give the vibrations in the calibrated scale. If some vibrations are coming, like 100 hertz, so we have one scale. Let us assume it may be calling it as calibrated scale. Let us take it as 5 volts for a 200 hertz. 10 volts like that, it is called calibrated scale. By seeing the voltage, output voltage, we can tell how many vibrations are coming from this machine. Okay, let us take the description. First part in the description is we are using piezoelectric crystals. In this space we have to keep the piezoelectric crystals. On both sides of the crystal, okay, this green color and this green color, both are electrodes. Okay, these electrodes are connected to the terminals, means electric wires, where we can measure the output voltage. In between these terminals, we can see the output voltage. Okay, so this is the first part in the description. So first part means piezoelectric crystals in between two electrodes. Take the next second part, some known value of mass we are keeping, some in terms of grams or in terms of some kgs like that. We are keeping some known value. Okay, we are keeping this mass on the crystal electrode arrangement. We are keeping this mass on the crystal electrode arrangement. Okay, this is the second part. Third part is we are keeping one plate here. It is called spring plate. This spring plate we are keeping above the mass. So why we are keeping spring means this spring will keep this mass and this arrangement crystal and electrode arrangement together. Okay, so this spring plate is the third part, and the fourth part is the entire arrangement, that is spring, mass, and then electrode, crystal, electrode arrangement. We are keeping in one housing. It is called housing frame. Above this housing frame, we are keeping one cover. Okay, this cover is touching this spring, as shown in the diagram. Okay, this cover is fitting to the housing frame by using nut and bolt arrangement. And these are the main four parts of the piezoelectric accelerometer. Let us take the working operation of this piezoelectric accelerometer. Here, this accelerometer is very small in size. Okay, whatever vibrations we have to measure, let us assume we have to measure the motor vibrations or motor acceleration we have to measure. We have to keep this accelerometer like this. Compared to motor size or lathe machine size, this accelerometer is very small. We have to fix this accelerometer above the surface of this motor or lathe machine like that. Okay, this is the accelerometer. In the working operation, we have to fix the accelerometer above the surface of the structure whose vibrations we have to measure or whose acceleration we have to measure. Now let us take, we are keeping this accelerometer on the surface of a machine or motor. Okay, so because of running of the motor, okay, it has vibrations. Because of vibrations, it will also vibrate up and down. Accelerometer will also move up and down. Here I have drawn arrows like this. It will also move up and down. Okay, we can call this as vibration or acceleration. Because of those vibrations, this spring will compress and it will apply the pressure, or it will press the mass. We are keeping some noun mass here. It will press the mass. So because of the pressing of the mass, this mass will apply the force on this electrode and crystal arrangement. So after pressing the mass, this mass will apply the force on the crystal. Okay, if we are applying the force on the crystals, let us take like this. Whatever crystals inside, different directions crystals will be. Okay, so just example I am telling. Some crystals are vertical, some crystals are horizontal, some crystals are inclined like that, like this. Let us take like this. With the application of the force, the orientation means the direction of the crystals will change. Let us take, if you are applying the pressure like this, force like this, this may come like this, or this may come like this. Okay, the orientation of each crystal will change. If the orientation of the crystals will change, in piezoelectric crystals, voltage will develop. Okay, so here in this area, because of change in orientation of crystals, voltage will develop inside the crystals. This voltage is picked by the electrodes. Here we are keeping the electric electrodes, which will take the voltage of the crystals. This voltage we can see at the output. Okay, it is called output voltage. These are the output terminals. Here if you are keeping this to the USB, okay, if you are keeping the to the USB, okay, if you are keeping to the computer or phone with the wire, okay, here if you are keeping USB to this output, if you are keeping to the cell phone or computer, we can see the waves like this in this display screen. Okay, so this voltage, whatever voltage is coming, the output voltage will measure the vibrations of this machine. Okay, this voltage will find the vibrations of this taken machine. Okay, this is the process of finding the acceleration or vibration by using the piezoelectric accelerometer. Here whatever force this mass is applying, we can write the equation F is equal to this mass into acceleration. Okay, as we know, this mass is noun mass. Some noun value we are keeping. It is constant. Okay, so that's why we can write the equation force is directly proportional to the acceleration. Okay, if acceleration is more, okay, whatever, if acceleration is more means vibrations are more, the meaning is the force applying this mass is also more. Okay, this force, okay, is finding the acceleration. How we can find this force means by using the output voltage. So in the short we can tell whatever output voltage is coming, it will measure the vibrations of a given machine. This is the main working operation of this accelerometer. What are the applications of this piezoelectric accelerometer means? We can measure the vibrations of motors, machines, drilling machines, lathe machines. Okay, and sometimes we can use in vehicles also. Advantages of this accelerometer is it is very small in size, okay, and easy to install at any place, and its cost is also less, and it is very sensitive. We can use for measuring wide range of vibrations. Will give correct reading of the vibrations of a machine. Let us take the limitations. Because of change in temperature, it will also change the output voltage here. Okay, it will give little different value to the ideal value. The next limitation is hysteresis error. Hysteresis error means the effect of the first experiment will come in the next experiment also. Because of that effect, some error will come in the output of the vibrations. It is called hysteresis error. So just in the simple way I will tell. Let us assume we are applying the load here. This is the some elongation. With the applied load, let us assume the curve is coming like this. Okay, this is input curve. And if you are unloading, this is the loading here. When we are loading, this will come, elongation will come like this. If you are doing unloading, the curve will come in this direction, not in the same path. Okay, this curve is called unloading. Okay, here this area is called hysteresis error. The meaning is the energy, whatever energy we are applying here for input loading, this energy, let us take E1, and during unloading, whatever energy we are using, that is E2. E1 minus E2 has some value, okay, some positive value. Okay, if it is in ideal condition, E1 is equal to E2, the change is 0. E1 minus E2 is 0. Means this accelerometer is in ideal condition. But in this accelerometer, we are getting some value here. This value is called hysteresis error. Why this hysteresis error will come means, this if you are using this instrument for finding the vibrations of motor initially, okay, again after finding the acceleration, again we are fixing here to the lathe machine for finding the vibrations. Whatever input effect will be there, the effect of the first experiment will come in the next experiment also. Because of that effect, some error will come in the output of the vibrations. It is called hysteresis error.